City Kids Detective Agency. Written by Jem Packer, illustrated by Andy Rowland. It was Joey who noticed something was wrong. "Mr. Fazak, Alfred is missing," he said. Alfred, a bearded dragon, was Mr. Fazak's favourite pet. Joey helped to look after Alfred for his neighbour. They both lived on the 14th floor of Basalt Towers.
"Poor Alfred. Where could he have gone?" said Mr. Fazak.
"This is a mission for the City Kids Detective Agency," said Joey. Joey, along with his younger sister Selma and her best friend Sonny, had solved the missing keys mystery and the case of the found phone just last week. Sonny wanted to start right away, zooming all over the neighbourhood and knocking on every door. "This isn't getting us anywhere," said Selma. "We need to think like a lizard." "Bearded dragons love to climb," said Joey. "Where would a climbing lizard go?"
"The playground by the skyscraper." The mission was live.
Joey made sure they all stayed together as they set off into the neighbourhood. Soon Sonny spotted his cousin, Big Paul, playing basketball.
"Yes, I saw a lizard on the climbing frame. He went that way," said Big Paul. "He looked hot."
"Where would a hot lizard go?" "Bearded dragons are great swimmers," said Joey. Selma knew exactly where to search. The fountain in the park, opposite the underground station. The park would be the perfect place to escape the heat and pollution of the city. Sonny was soon up to his knees in water. Joey scanned the busy park. Selma started quizzing people, and soon she saw her uncle in his ice cream van.
"I saw a lizard earlier, Selma," said Mr. Lolly. "He looked hungry."
"Where would a hungry lizard go?" Joey knew that bearded dragons love to eat crickets and worms. They also like vegetables. It had to be Miss Hotpot's Veggie Cafe. "It's near the train station, by the commercial district, near those new office buildings," said Selma. The friends walked through the residential area by the estate. They hurried past the cathedral to the train station. "Hello, kids. Have a broccoli smoothie," smiled Miss Hotpot. Sonny dashed around the cafe while Joey looked under every table. Selma asked Miss Hotpot some questions.
"A lizard?" nodded Miss Hotpot. "I remember. I made him a sweet potato and pepper salad. He seemed tired."
"Where would a tired lizard go?"
Then Selma had one last idea, an idea that required transport.
They took a bus along the busy high street full of traffic. The congestion made the short journey a slow one, but the detectives were determined.
"It's our last hope," said Selma, spotting the shop.
"Mr. Snore's bed store," said Sonny. "We bought my baby sister's cot here."
"A sleepy lizard," said Mr. Snore. "Have a look around."
Sonny bounced on and off every bed. Joey searched under every pillow. "Bearded dragons need total darkness to sleep," Joey said.
"Maybe he's hidden away at the very back," said Selma.
Sonny finally heard a strange snoring. Selma could tell it was coming from the furthest, darkest corner of the storeroom.
"There you are, Alfred," chuckled Joey. "I thought you'd run away to the suburbs."
"We need to get you home," smiled Selma.
Mr. Fazak was so pleased to see his lost lizard. He promised to make him sweet potato and pepper salad every day.
"Thank you," he grinned. "We've all missed him."
"Another successful mission for the City Kids Detective Agency," beamed Selma.
"I can't wait for the next one," said Sonny.
"Alfred could join us," smiled Joey. "He certainly knows his way around the neighbourhood."